everyone, my name is Shweta. Today we learn how to play chess. We start from the scratch. So first of all, my first question is just tell me what's the shape of chessboard. And the option is square or rectangle. Okay, if your answer is square, that's your answer is correct. But if your answer is rectangle, so you are wrong. I give you one example so it's easy for you to understand. Okay, just see my phone. My phone shape is rectangle. Why is rectangle? Because two sides are equal and these two sides are equal. Okay, that's why the shape of my phone is rectangle. Now see the chessboard. This side is equal to this side. This side is equal to this side. It means all sides are equal to each other. That's why this is a square. Clear? Okay. Now the second is, okay, let's see what's the name of the pieces. So this is king. The spelling of this piece is K-I-N-G, king. This piece name is queen. The spelling is Q-U-E-E-N. Now the spelling of rook. This is a rook and the spelling of rook. And sometimes we call a rook, I'm coming. So that's a rook. It's easy to you to learn. Okay. This is bishop. The spelling is B-I-S-H-O-P, bishop. This one is knight. The spelling is, you say no, day and night. So simply just write the knight spelling and just add K. And the last one is pawn. This is a pawn and the spelling is P-A-W-N, pawn. Clear? So again, this is a king, this is a queen, this is a rook, this is a bishop, this is a knight, and this is a pawn. Clear? Okay, now we talk about the nicknames. You also have nicknames. Mama call you sometimes cutie pie or with your different names. So now I tell you the nickname of the pieces. So king, the first alphabet of king spelling is K. So the king nickname is king. Now tell me the queen nickname, Q. Rook nickname, R. Bishop nickname, B. Pawn is too small. If you see all the pieces, pawn is too smaller. So we not give any nickname to pawn. And now we talk about the knight. Knight spelling is also start from K and the king spelling is also start from K. But king is more important. Without king, we not play the game. So that's why K is for king and N is for knight. Clear? So if I talk about the nicknames, king nickname is K, queen nickname Q, rook nickname R, bishop nickname B, knight nickname N, and pawn P, or pawn has no nickname. Very nice. Pawn has no nickname. Clear? Okay. Now we talk about, if you see the chessboard, there is an alphabet as well as a numbers. Like, now I remove all the pieces. See, there is a number and alphabet. A, B, C, D, E, up to H. As well as there is a number. A, 1, 2, 3, up to 8. So now the question is, why in the chessboard there is an alphabet or number? See, you sit in the different country, or you can say state, or you can say place. Okay. So you simply say, okay, ma'am, just move this bishop to right hand side. I'm saying where right? Because there's a lot of square towards the right hand side. You can say, ma'am, up, up, up. So I'm saying where? It's difficult to arrange a particular piece. It takes a lot of time. So what we learn, what we do, we simply write the alphabet as well number. So it's easy for you to tell to other person where you want to place your piece. Like first I give an example. Suppose I put my bishop to randomly one square like this. Okay. Now if you tell the position of this bishop, so you can simply say E. First see the alphabet, that's E. and then see the number. So number is 4. So bishop position is e4. Clear? Now we talk about the, now I change the bishop position. So right now the bishop position is c6. c6. Okay. Now I change the bishop position again. Now the bishop position is g2. Clear? And this is a h1. If you see clearly, there is a h and number is 1. So this square name is h1. So you can use same method with all the pieces. Like if I arrange the queen to this position, so you can simply say e5. If I arrange the knight, b3. If we talk about the pawn, you can simply say g2. Now your turn. I arrange the piece. Okay, now I give you 10 seconds. Tell me what's the position of this rook. Excellent, d5. Now tell me the position of this rook. Excellent, b7. Now I'm not make the arrows. What you do, you simply use your finger and then make an arrow. Simply use your finger and just move in on your screen and then tell me the position of the piece. So now I take the queen. Yeah, I give you 10 seconds. Focus and tell me what's the position of the queen. Go down. If you go down, the alphabet is E. Very nice. If you go right, then the number is 4. Very nice. So queen position is E4. The queen position is E4. One more example. Now, again, I give you 10 seconds. Focus and then tell me the position. Very nice. B. Now go right. And the alpha, the number is 7. So king position is B7. Clear? So it's easy for you to tell to other person ki where you want to arrange the piece. Simply you can say, if you want to move F6, you simply say F6 moves the knight F6. So you can simply arrange. It's take less time. Clear? Okay. So one more time, what's the name of this piece? King, and the nickname K. This piece name is Queen and nickname is Q. Very nice. This piece name is Rook and nickname R. This piece name is Bishop and nickname is B. This piece name is Knight and nickname is N, because K is a silent, or you can say K, we already give K to King. Now this piece name is pawn and nickname. Who say P? Nobody. So what's the nickname of P? No, Nick, the pawn has no nickname. Clear? Very nice. Okay. Now we discuss ki how the pieces move. And after that, we learn ki how, in the next session, we learn how to arrange the pieces. So we talk about only two pieces, ki how the pieces move. We talk about the rook. Okay, now I arrange the rook at d5 position. See, everyone know na ki how to make a plus. Use your hand and make a plus. Very nice. Hana, you make a plus in your math subject. Plus. So the rook move like a plus, like up, down, right and left. So you can say the rook move in 4 direction, up, down, right and left. Clear? And there's a no limitation. Rook can move one step in one move, in one shot, or you can simply move the rook 3 step ahead or just in one shot. Like the rook position is this, d2-5. So you can simply move in one shot d8 like this. Or if the rook position is d1, so you can move your rook anywhere like d8 in one shot. If you don't want to move last line, you can simply go d3. Means there's a no limitation. If the your rook position is this, you can move right, left, down, and up. Like a plus. Okay. Now every student know na how to make a bish, how to make a cross. Again, use your hand, go fast. Again, use your hand and make a cross. Very nice. So it means the bishop make a cross like this and this. Clear? So I simply arrange the bishop at d5. So the bishop move like this. You notice right now if I talk about, there is a two color. Okay, in the chess board, there is a two color. Few students have chess board which color is white and black. Few combination you see green and white. There's a different combination, but always in the chess board, there's a two color. Okay, right now, what's the background of the bishop? You can say cream, some people say white, it's okay. So that's a white color, you can say cream color. So this bishop only move in white square. Okay, this bishop not go to brown square, or you can say black square, or in your chess board there is a green square. It means if the bishop background is white, the bishop only move in white square. Suppose there is another bishop and the bishop background color is brown, so the bishop only move in brown square, like this. Clear? Any doubt in this? If you have any doubt, just put your comments and ask. I'll try to give answer as early as possible. Thank you. Hope so you enjoy this video. Bye-bye.